Hey guys, before this video starts, I want to let you guys know that on August 22nd, we're having our first merch drop in so long. We got some really cool brand new items. We got these pink and black dad hats. We got a brand new shirt that Cody's wearing now in black, a Krispy Media with donuts on the front, with sprinkles on the front. Sorry, Cody, spin around. On the back, we have our premium visuals designs right here with the donut in the middle, and then Krispy Media premium visual trademark right there. And then we also have this new white shirt right here, Krispy Media, around some lightning bolts in the colors, and it's also well, bam, there on the back, just a little bit bigger. This will be on the website as well in that merch drop, along with a restock of the cream embroidered hoodies. You guys wanted these so bad. You wanted them back in stock. They are coming back in stock on the August 22nd drop. You'll be able to get these in cream, and these are the embroidered hoodies once again. And we also have two new stickers. One sticker here that matches the shirt that I'm wearing, and then another sticker here that matches the embroidered hoodie. This one's got a cool, like, glittery to it. And this one's white here with the premium visuals as well. That hat is also available in the drop. That's in black and pink. Oh, wait. And pink. So that's all. Those are all the new items in this shop. Hold on. Phone's ringing.
Whoa!
Hello?
Is that a Krispy phone case?
No, Cody's not working on the car right now.
Okay.
Yeah, he's the only one that works on the car. I don't do anything.
Right.
He does everything.
He's admitting it, finally.
Yeah, okay. And we also have Krispy Media phone cases. So if you guys check the website, August 22nd, 12 p.m., brand new merch shop, two new shirts, restock of the hoodie, two new stickers, two new dad hats, and a phone case. Check it out, Krispy.store on August 22nd. That's Saturday at 12 p.m. Standard Eastern Time. Cody, should they buy the merch?
Hell yeah, you should.
It's a good answer. Phil, you think they should buy the merch?
Hell yeah.
Guys, buy the merch. Show us some love. Support us. Let's get to the video, guys. Also, we forgot to mention one more thing. There's also going to be some limited edition mystery boxes included in this drop with a bunch of items in there that you guys are going to be able to get. They're going to be limited edition. So, Cody, what should they do?
You should buy the box.
Buy their mystery box before they set out. They're going to go fast along
grab
with all this new merch.
Grab it.
We can't say that.
Fuck, you're right.
Cody, I was a little late because a little something showed up in front of my door.
What was that?
I thought the same thing. Our extra lip is already here.
No shit.
Pretty quick. Hey, eBay is quicker than most shippers right now. You guys saw in the last video, we ordered a backup eBay lip to mock to go on the legacy for when the carbon fiber one explodes. Yes, Cody?
Oh, my fan.
Yes, I kept your fan in the car.
I love this thing, dude.
So this is just like a poly lip that'll match our JDM bumper.
Oh, we still have the carbon fiber one that was ruined by someone.
No.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
You ordered this like 2 days ago.
Yeah, in the vlog. And it's here. This was eBay.
Dude, I thought this was like the one from Japan. The carbon.
No, they're
the
closed.
Carbon fiber one.
We can't ship to them right now. Also, that's like
$500. That's what I was confused.
This was quick because this is eBay. I never expect eBay to order this quick. Anyway, just a polyurethane lip for the legacy because that the carbon one breaks. I want to have this one as a backup.
When?
Yeah, when. It breaks. I want to have this one as a backup so we have at least some lip to write on the car. But what are we doing today, Cody?
So today, we're going...
Sorry. I'll do it over for when we blow up the carbon fiber lip on the car. So what are you doing today, Cody?
There we go. We're going to... This is going after yesterday, right?
Whenever.
Okay. As you guys saw in one of the vlogs that we have power steering leak, we're going to try and tighten that fitting first before we...
Order new shit.
My favorite pastime is making Chris spend money. So we're going to tackle that, and then we're going to install the microphone on the radio. When we put the interior back together, we kind of forgot to put the mic on. So he's on the phone with his dad, and his dad's like, what? And he's getting mad, but whatever. That's fun. Let's get to it, because my girlfriend is home, and she's pissed that I'm here.
Alright, so we're back here at the storage unit with the Legacy. We're going to do, like Cody said, a few small things here. We're going to try to spend a quick time. We don't spend too much time because it's still super hot out. We don't have lights in the unit, so we want to use what's left of our sunlight and then get on out of here. But we have a few.
If you sponsored this video, we can have all the lights we need.
Yeah. So we're just going to get a few things done really quickly. Also, if you didn't look, you didn't see yet, I got that new merch on. I got that new Krispy Media Premium Visuals t-shirt on right now. It's going to be going live on... Cody, when was that again? August 22nd, you're right, August 22nd.
August 22nd, and get the sick dad hat.
Oh, woo! You got the dad hat on too.
Yeah.
Grab that merch, boys, August 22nd. All right, let's do car stuff. Let's do legacy stuff. It still looks like it's coming off a jump. Should I off-road the legacy one day? Honestly, there's some nice light on your face right now.
I need...
Yes, I'm on it. What do you need, bud?
The black case
Red case?
Yeah.
You said open it up and slide it under. I wasn't done.
I wasn't sure you were open it up the right way. I
chance
it.
Cody, I do like your toolbox. I'm not going to lie.
Well, Milwaukee sponsor us.
I don't think I'll ever get tired of seeing that turbo at the grill. Plus the Circuit Demon headlights. I think this grill, a lot of you guys asked, this grill is just from eBay. It's an eBay carbon fiber grill. It's like the only non-authentic part on the whole car. Ugh, this view looks amazing. At points like this during, you know, working on the car and when stuff's going on with the car where I don't really have any knowledge and would just harm the situation and make things go longer, I'm just kind of letting Cody do his thing, chilling here and helping him out when he needs help. In the meantime, we're kind of just hanging out. He's looking over stuff. He's doing his thing. I'm going to try to not get in his way too much because you love it when I get in your way, right? See? Because that happens. And then we get an angry Cody, and no one likes an angry Cody. I know a lot of you guys also out there in the comments of all the recent videos are also saying, dude, get it open, like, full throttle. Like, dude, give us a full throttle kit, all that type of jazz. I'm going to wait till, again, everything is buttoned up on the car and ready to go, and I feel a little bit more comfortable in the car. I just don't want to full send it out of the gate. I know I want to so bad. I know you guys want me to so bad. But obviously for, like, safety things, and this car is expensive now. It's not a $5,000 roller shell anymore or anything like that, right? It's an expensive car at the same time, so I need to keep that in mind. But that aside, we are going to have some fun with it. Again, once everything's all buttoned up, put together, and we're fully ready to really have some fun with it, we'll do some like raw POV clips, just like driving. I'll put a GoPro to my head. I'll put GoPros on the outside of the car. I'll put all my professional mics on the car, and we'll get a really cool, just pure sound driving video for you guys. And we'll try to bang through all the gears, and we'll try to like rev it out. We'll get some pops and bangs. We'll do all that type of stuff. That'll be in an upcoming video. Again, once you just feel a little bit more comfortable with it. And also I'll tease here, I think we've talked about it a bunch, but we're trying to land a cross-country road trip with this car from New York to Portland to LA to San Jose to Texas to Florida to Virginia, Georgia, and then back up to New York, hopefully this October. There's going to be like no shows or anything going on, so I got the whole month free. We're trying to figure that out. That's in the planning stages right now. If that happens, obviously we'll make a video about it, letting you guys know. We'll try to do maybe some mini safety, social distancing meetups along the way. Meet up with some of your favorite YouTubers, do some collaborations, film some really cool cars. Obviously, I'd stop at a bunch of cool national parks and stuff like that. But I would love to do that in the Legacy and the minivan with me and some friends and just take a month and go explore the country and film this car all over. We're just trying to figure out a sponsor for that right now because it's going to be a lot of money to bring me and my friends and these two cars across the country creating content every day, daily vlogs, and then an overall cinematic recap at the end of the month too for an entire month. So that's in the planning stages. Keep that in the back of your minds. If you'd be interested in that, let me know in the comments down below. Is that something you want to do? If so, like, what state should we stop in? Because there's no deadlines, realistically. There's nowhere we have to be at any certain time. We can do collaborations with other YouTubers whenever we get there. The only real deadlines are getting to some of these cool state parks before they close for winter. So if there's a certain state, certain YouTuber, somebody you think we should collaborate with, put it in the comments down below. We're already talking with Dustin Williams, TJ, Eliminate, LZ, That Dude in Blue, BS Rebuild, and some other guys as well, like VinWiki. And I think that'd be an amazing way to spend a COVID month where we can't normally do it at any shows or anything like that. Just, you know, being safe, traveling around the country in a 700, almost 700 horsepower car in my minivan full of camera gear and spare parts, of course, because it is a Subaru and a few quarts of oil. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Give me your opinions and maybe some places we should stop. But hopefully that happens this October. But Cody's tinkering away. We'll check in with him in a second.
Oh yeah, that's fucked. Yeah. Yeah, it's fucked. Yeah, that's fucked.
The line or the fitting?
Yeah, it's all fucked.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the line.
It looks like the fitting was on, however, it was leaking. And then upon removal, we had to kind of get aggressive. I'm going to take this to my shop. We're going to cut this off and we're going to weld one of these fittings to that. I have access to these but in steel. So then we don't need an adapter. As long as it works on this, then we're going to order a new line from Subaru because it's just get OEM lines like this.
Yeah.
And then we can go from there. But I'm pretty confident that I can just weld this fitting directly to it. Not this one. This is aluminum.
Are you confident that's where the leak was coming from?
That's where the leak was coming from.
Got it. Okay.
So if this goes well,
yeah,
I'm going to have him order both lines, and I'm going to weld fittings to both sides.
You guys remember when he talked about me spending money? This is what we're
waiting. Maybe the lines are cheap. They're like $22. But,
oh, cool. That's not bad.
No, not bad at all.
That's good.
Which is good practice, because when I do a 15 STIC and rack on my Forester, I might have to do the same thing. So, for the dump. But yeah, that's basically all.
This is good practice.
It is as far as we can go, as far as doing things right. The good thing is it's the power steering system. So it's not like you're going to have loss of oil pressure or anything like that. The worst case, you lose your fluid. Now you have a manual rack. You burned up a pump. You're still going to get home.
Worst case is we're not even going to, or the case is we're not even going to be driving it right now anyway.
Correct.
So
that's why I feel confident as far as what the repair is going to be on the power steering system. Because like I said, if it fails, it's its own system. It's not like we're fucking around. It's not like we're messing around with something that's like oil or coolant related that cause engine failure. This is just going to cause power steering system failure. But then we get to put a brand new BRZ steering rack in the car. Yeah.
Mm-mm.
Sponsored.
I bought an eBay lip, Cody. I don't have...
It's the intercooler that's right next to my head is worth more than my car, okay?
And you mean that cool-looking toaster over there?
That is a cool-looking toaster.
It's a cool-looking toaster.
You know
toaster.
Where you can see more of that? On my YouTube channel.
Cars and Cody. Yep, yeah, there it is.
The video is coming out... Well,
eventually.
All right, never mind. By the time you see this video, I'll have a new video up.
Facts.
Yeah.
For now, we're going to move on from the power steering. We'll address this again at a later date and time, maybe next week or the week after.
What? Yeah. Totally.
Hopefully, because obviously me and Cody both want to drive this car. We want to get it back out of some meets and stuff like that.
I have like six people that I need to give rides to, so if we can hurry this up, it'd be great.
We?
If you can hurry up this purchasing process.
I'll do it right now. I'll do it on my phone. Hey, Siri.
Whoa.
So in the meantime, we'll leave this aside. What do you want to tackle? What do you want to try to tackle next today? Small issue on the inside of the car with our Bag Riders DigiGauge. They don't make it anymore, and the screen just, I'll put a picture here. It started to go off the screen. The numbers started to go off the screen. So we're just literally going to try to unplug that and plug it back in and see if that fixes our issue. If not, we might just get a new screen from them. And also, we never put in back our microphone for our Sony head unit. Be able to make phone calls and stuff hands-free in the car. Because obviously, we're going to need both hands on the wheel when we got 700 horsepowers. First, Cody's just going to take apart this like center dash piece right here and plug back in our DigiGauge. Yeah, we had this custom piece made when we were doing the interior. DID did like this custom piece, and then we had it carbon fibered over. So we want this to work, because it looks really cool and we have a custom setup for it. So we're literally just going to try to unplug it and plug it back in and see if that fixes the issue we put here on screen. Nobody knows if that will. We don't know if that will. If it does, great. If not, we are going to have to buy another $109 screen just for this little thing to tell us our air ride. But our pressures.
You hand me the Phillips screwdriver.
Easy does it. The lid. The lid. The lid.
The lid, the lid, the lid.
Oh, yeah.
I like taking the interior parts like apart because it just pops and everything, but I'm having like anxiety with this stuff.
You guys remember we did all the forged purple carbon fiber. You guys can see it over here. We did forged purple carbon fiber for all our like silver interior trim. So obviously doing all this is super sketchy and super scary because we don't want to break or ruin anything because it's pretty much at this point irreplaceable. So we don't
want to ruin doing any of that. Yeah.
You said so you're doing it?
Yeah.
I could break it.
No, because guess who has to figure out how to fix it?
Well, my bank account would have to figure that out. And they would be like, hey man, you're trying to buy a house, stop. And I'd be like, you're right.
There's Chris flexing on buying a house.
Some of you guys asked too in the past. This is a Sony XAC or XAV 100 head unit or something like that. It's for our double din. I forget exactly what it was.
It's in the description of the install video.
Oh, and I'll put it in the description of this one, but with an Amazon affiliate link. If you guys want to check it out. Also, I think they updated it since this version, because this version, the volume knob is super, super hard. Here, Cody, let me show you an example of what the volume knob is like twisted. The volume knob is really hard to twist, because it's so close to the bezel. So I don't recommend getting this one, but get the updated one.
Bezel, bezel. Fucking idiot.
Dude, I'm going to bezel your bezel.
Where do we put it? Right there?
What? No.
It works.
Not at all. Hide it in the AC, since it won't be blown anyway. Yeah, I wouldn't care there. This is more functionality than looks for this piece, so.
Mine's literally just hanging loose.
Well, you also drive a Forester, so.
You're such a fucking.
Oh, actually, the sunlight on that fits too right now, bro.
On the pieces?
No, on the microphone.
Oh. Oh, man.
That's tight too, because I can just unclip that for like feature shots.
Yes, sir. Fucking shit, you fucking geriatric fuck.
Dude!
What?
New YouTube! We can't be doing that.
I know, you're not gonna put any of that in.
Watch me. Be gentle, it's my first time. Can't even get it in the hole, dude, come on. It's so big.
It's so funny, like the Forester. I barely ever had the interior part, but the Accuair, I think I've had like the radio out like 30 times.
Dude, somebody asked yesterday in the comments, dude, where's Cody's Accuair? I haven't seen that thing in so long, can we bring that back? And I was like, ugh, that's long gone. Sorry.
That's the wrong car.
You are not the car. Cameraman. Oh!
I put the walk-off plate on my car.
Mm-hmm.
Drove once, was like, I'm like, yeah, no. I'm gonna take this back off. I'll take the psh.
Psh. We've heard that sound before when my bags popped.
The most uneasy feeling ever.
And just like that, our microphone is plugged in, so now we could use our Siri and Apple CarPlay on the on the dash over there, and we could just unclip that for feature photos and video stuff, and our dash is back together. We'll see if the DigiGauge works in the next video when we start the car up. We just don't want to start it up right now or key on, because Cody mentioned the car is on air ride and it is staying on these jack stands that it's currently on, and we don't want the air ride to mess with the jack stands because Cody's still got to go underneath there. But we'll let you know if the DigiGauge, stay tuned next week to find out if the DigiGauge turns on and if it works. If not, Chris is out $109.
Yes.
I've never noticed this before until the sunlight hits it right here, and I've just noticed it, but we could see our vibrant titanium through the back of the hood cowl because we have the hood risers on there right now, a little bit more heat out, but we could see some of the vibrant titanium in Ryan's welds from Area 1320 through the hood mount and the HD clamp underneath there from Vibrant. That's so cool! At some point as well, if anybody out there is interested that has a Legacy, these are Cody's, don't get any idea. I'm going to put up for sale the exhaust that Ryan made for SEMA with the little upturns, with the NVIDIA exhaust times Ryan's custom exhaust. So I'm going to put that up at
with
some point.
Turn down tips. Turn down for what tips? They're, yeah, what?
They turn up. Anyway, Cody doesn't know what he's talking about, guys. He doesn't know anything about cars. And then at some point, I might auction off my old Circuit Demon headlights, maybe, or do something with those in a giveaway or something, possibly. And I also have some other old, like, Legacy parts, like the seats and some other stuff I might put up for sale one day. Once I get everything back here in the storage unit, I'm going to just make a post and put a bunch of stuff for sale. So look out for that. I'll post on, like, Instagram when that stuff does go for sale or a giveaway, whatever we do want to do with the headlights and the exhaust and all type of jazz. So look out for that at some point if you guys own the Legacy out there, or if you just want something from the Legacy build. Just another quick vlog here, checking out the Legacy in the unit. We're doing, like, Cody works a regular job, so we can't spend all day in the car. He kind of just comes here, spends an hour or two after work, and then goes back home. So in those hour or two, we just see how much we can get done. Today was taking off the power steering lines, figuring out exactly what the problem was and a solution for that. So we figured that out at least, and then getting in the little small thing like the, what is it? Microphone. Getting our microphone in the car. We're going to adjust the trunk today, but we're going to run out of time on that for now. So we'll take care of that the next time that we come to the unit, which will probably be next week at some point. And yeah, hopefully she'll be back out on the road in a week or two and we could get some more videos for you guys. And August 22nd. It's really bright. August 22nd. Merch shop. Fire merch, hats, hoodies. Make sure you guys cop something off this new merch shop. It's going to be awesome. Any support is amazing, whether you guys get a sticker or a shirt or just spread the merchandise if you're wearing it or if you purchased it. Make a story of it. I'll reblog your story or I'll reshare your story on Instagram stories if you get the merch. August 22nd, whenever that is in relative whatever to this video comes out. If that's tomorrow, get it. If it already happened, you probably slept and missed all the stuff because it's probably sold out because I love you guys so much. Yeah, that's it for Legacy for today. Just something short, quick, simple. Give you guys another look at the Legacy. I hope you guys aren't getting tired of Legacy videos. We're going to go film a cool feature tomorrow. So it'll be a fun little feature coming up on the channel of a Baja. My friend's Baja, Super Baja. We're going to obviously try to film more features coming in the future because there are no car shows. So we're going to try to fill that in with cool car features and Legacy content. So hopefully you guys are looking forward to that stuff on the channel. Thank you guys again. Make sure you guys thumbs up this video, comment, like, subscribe, do all that good YouTube stuff. And we'll see you guys in the next one. August 22nd, 12 p.m. Merch shop. Thanks, guys.